So Disney just released its remake of the 1994 animated film, The Lion King. Now there has been a lot of hype surrounding this film as Disney is remaking such a beloved classic. But in recent years, Disney seems to be heavily relying on nostalgia by turning their classic animated films into live-action ones. While there were three live-action remakes prior to 2010, the release of Alice in Wonderland really marked the turning point in the company, where animated to live-action was going to become the norm. And as you can see, there are a bunch more of these remakes to come. Recently, The Little Mermaid announced its casting decision for Ariel, and the Mulan teaser trailer premiered during the Women's FIFA World Cup. Go Team USA, by the way. And even the Maleficent sequel got a trailer. While a large majority of people are excited to see their favorite childhood stories and characters again in a reimagined way on the big screen, there are also those who are not as enthusiastic to see these classic Disney movies in the theaters, myself being one of them. And the reason for that is the animation in The Lion King remake is lacking. Now, when I say this, I don't mean to say that it's bad. I can't sit here and look at something like this and say this is bad animation. On a technical level, this animation is incredible. Being able to create such realism in a computer is definitely impressive. But just because you can create such realism, should you? Because the thing about the animation in the remake of The Lion King is that it has lost all the charm, expression, and life from the original. Now, I'm not even the biggest fan of the original Lion King. I'm not sure I would even put it in my top 10 favorite Disney movies. Not to say that it's bad by any means, it just never really appealed to me when I was younger, or even now. But as I look back on the film now, whether it was one of my favorite movies or not, I can tell that this film has heart. Before I get into the in-depth comparison and analysis, keep in mind that at the time of me writing and recording this script, I have yet to see The Lion King remake in theaters. I'm going to be looking at the original Lion King, The Lion King remake, and Detective Pikachu mainly based on the trailers to point out why people are taking issue with Disney remakes in general, but The Lion King specifically. This video is not meant to be a review of each film in its entirety, rather a look at the creative and animation process and how it can limit a film. So with all of that out of the way, let's get into it. I think the best way to show this is to compare screenshots from the trailers of the original and the remake, because the remake did a shot-for-shot of the 1994 trailer. And while, yeah, it's cool they did a shot-for-shot remake, it points out some of the issues that myself and others have with the film. First off, color. By setting yourself in a realistic setting, you lose a bunch of color, and color is one of the things that viewers are drawn to whether they know it or not when watching. Color theory is its own topic, and one I won't cover in this video, but essentially color theory is how colors work together and create appealing color palettes. In 2D animation, there really is not a limit to what colors you can use, so with this opening shot here, we can really see the satisfying transition from the darks to a deep red, compared to the remake where the colors are more muted and there isn't as much of a contrast. Also, seriously, like, you couldn't have just centered the sun more in this shot here. And you can also see the major difference in color here. You have a very bright, vibrant morning sky in the original, and more or less the same colors that we saw in the previous shot from the remake. And again, we see a big difference in the use of color here with this shot of birds flying over some wetlands. You can clearly see the flamingos are a bright pink, and that contrasts directly with the dark green below of the land. The contrast of the colors is what makes this shot so interesting, and you also get a bit of the reflection from the sun rising here with the orange. This is the last screenshot that I'll look at regarding color, and it's a shot of Pride Rock. I mean, I could go into detail, but I think you can just see by looking at it how much more lush, vibrant, and full of life the original looks. Like, you know in the movie when Scar takes over and everything dies and Pride Rock looks all gloomy? This shot from the remake is kind of like the in-between point between those two. So why is color so important here? Well, we know that the songs will be included in the remake. The shots we just saw are all from the Circle of Life. And based on those, we can see that there just isn't as much use of color. Now, think about songs like I Just Can't Wait to Be King and Be Prepared. I Just Can't Wait to Be King has a lot of color, and I mean a lot of color, like almost to the point of, oh god, I need some sunglasses here. Seriously, look at all the color. How the hell is the remake gonna pull this off? While the song itself is iconic, when watching the film, the visuals are adding to it. The music and animation should work together to create the best musical number it possibly can. While the song in the remake might be good, it just isn't going to be able to pull off these kinds of colors and visuals because of the restraints they have put on themselves. The same can be said for Be Prepared. In the song, we go from bright greens to yellows to a sinister red. If the remake isn't pushing or exaggerating lighting at all, how is the film going to be able to execute this? Now, I am a decent ways through this video, and I have only mentioned the other film I have put in this title once, that being Detective Pikachu. Detective Pikachu is similar to The Lion King in the sense that it is something beloved by children of the 90s and had a film released in 2019. Plus, both these films aim to create a sense of realism. But Detective Pikachu exceeded in what The Lion King remake lacked. Now, I just went over color and lighting with The Lion King, so now let's take a look at Detective Pikachu. Color is probably going to be one of the first things that jumps out at you regarding Detective Pikachu. I mean, just look at the posters and promotional material for this movie. They definitely embrace the use of color and lighting. But just take a look at some of these shots from the Detective Pikachu trailers. Compared to the Lion King trailer, they use light and color in far more interesting ways. And to me, this tells me that the filmmakers fully utilize their setting of Rhyme City and use the bright lights of a bustling city to their advantage to make unique and interesting shots. And it's not just the lighting in the environment, the Pokemon themselves have color that matches their 2D designs. The yellow of Pikachu and Psyduck's fur are still the classic bright yellow. Both Charizard and Magikarp maintain their orange color, but in the film they have scales and texture to make them look more realistic. The same goes for Bulbasaur, the texture gives a more realistic look, but the color palette is practically unchanged. Compare this to the Lion King remake and you can see that the characters have not maintained their iconic 2D designs and colors. Which brings me to the topic of character design and expression. Character design is incredibly important when it comes to animated films. When I studied animation in college, I heard from my instructors that the design of the character itself should be able to convey what a character is about. I think Disney's villain designs really embody this idea best. Take a look at Hades, Ursula, and the Lion King's own Scar. Just one look at these characters and you can already get a rough idea of their personalities. Now let's take Scar's design and compare that to Mufasa's to show the contrast. Mufasa is essentially the embodiment of a strong, kind-hearted king. His design shows him being fairly large and muscular, especially when compared to Scar. His fur is gold with a deep red mane, red and gold being colors that often represent royalty but can also symbolize the rising sun, which is the first shot that we get in the film. This can be pushed further with the song Circle of Life, which is the ideology that Mufasa lives by. Fun fact, in the Broadway adaptation of The Lion King, costume designer Julie Taymor said she felt Mufasa embodied the sun, which is why the character's mask is circular. Quote, obviously Mufasa is the sun, that's why we have the circle. He's very much about symmetry and radiation, the sun god. So even in the Broadway adaptation, elements of Mufasa's original design are heavily present. Now let's look at Scar. In direct contrast to Mufasa, Scar is thinner and scrawnier. His fur color is brown and his mane is black. The choice of color for his mane and fur are dark, which directly contrasts with Mufasa's bright colors. The mane itself is also not as full, being somewhat unkempt and more scraggly looking. One of the most notable features of Scar's design and also symbolism in his character are his eyes, which are bright green. The green referring to the idiom green with envy. And the color green is also very prominent in the song Be Prepared, which is a song that perfectly captures Scar's motivations, those being he is envious of his brother and he wants to be king. So the choice of green eyes is an excellent one for Scar. But now let's take a look at the designs for the Lion King remake. Those are lions, all right. Seriously, you could just take any one of these images and put it on a National Geographic magazine, and I wouldn't think twice. But remember how I said that the character design is really important in being able to convey symbolism and the character's personality? Yeah, we don't get that here. I guess Scar is the closest we get to having a unique character design, but he doesn't have anything from his original design besides the scar. They didn't give him a black mane to contrast with Mufasa. He doesn't have the piercing green eyes to symbolize his motivations. He's just a grumpy, mangy-looking lion. He doesn't have that suave, conniving attitude about him that you could just pick up on from his original design. He just looks emotionless. And this goes for all the characters. They all just look like regular animals. If you blocked out the names and you came up to me and told me this is Simba, I'd be like, yeah, okay. Or if you asked me to pick which one is Nala or Sarabi, or which one is young Simba or young Nala, I wouldn't know. And I get it, for this remake they wanted to make them as real as possible, but in doing so you lose everything that made these character designs so unique and iconic. But let's change gears and look at Detective Pikachu. For this, I'm just going to have some screenshots up here of some of the Pokemon that appeared in Detective Pikachu and their 2D designs. What you'll probably notice immediately is that the 3D designs look just like their 2D ones. Hell, they even kept the proportions of each Pokemon the same. And what I mean by this is that if you look at something like the Sonic the Hedgehog trailer, the design of Sonic is nothing like his 2D one unless you get this very weird, strange looking design where Sonic appears to have human-like legs and a body, but his hands are a combo of a human and a hedgehog, and the head doesn't feel proportionate. It's just an odd design overall. But with Detective Pikachu, all the Pokemon maintain their proportions of their 2D designs, thus keeping the integrity of the characters. And when you do that, it's easy to identify what each Pokemon is. That's Pikachu. That's Venusaur. That's a Jigglypuff, and so on. The film didn't lose what made each Pokemon design unique, rather just add realism through texture. Compare this to the Lion King remake where the original designs were completely stripped away and all you are left with are just lions. But this leads me to my final point of expression. I briefly mentioned this before, but when looking at these posters of the Lion King remake, there is no emotion here. And emotion and exaggeration are a huge part of what makes animation so unique and limitless. When restricting yourself to realism, there is only so much emotion you can pull off, especially when you are using photorealistic lions and animals. I've picked just a handful of screenshots from the original film that I feel exude emotion and expression. Now, when looking at these, I asked myself, how the hell is this movie gonna pull off this level of expression? And to put it simply, they can't. From the moment they chose to go for realism, they immediately limited their potential for showing dynamic emotion. And we've already seen a glimpse at one of the most pivotal scenes in the film, that being Mufasa's death. Here's the original.
Run away and never return.
And here's the remake.
And never return.
In this one shot, you could see how pained Simba is at the death of his father and how he feels he was responsible for it. In the remake, there's just nothing. Oh no, I guess. And if this is how one of the most well-known scenes in the film is going to be treated, how are the others? What about the actual moment of Mufasa's death? The cold-blooded look of Scar and the shock of Mufasa? Probably not gonna get that here. Or what about scenes that I already mentioned, like Just Can't Wait to Be King and Be Prepared? I already talked about color, but the expressions in these scenes are top-notch animation, and in the remake, they're just not gonna be there. Which is incredibly disappointing to see, because whether viewers know it or not, the emotion and expression that were present in The Lion King is a large part of what made this movie so beloved. And now all I'm thinking about looking back at the original is how strange and awkward it's going to be when things are happening to the characters and they aren't going to be able to show it through emotion at all. Or how the hell is it going to look when they do this scene?
Wow! If you're hungry for a hunk of fat and juicy meat, eat my body pumper here because he has a treat.
Seriously, how are they going to take a scene like this and use photorealistic animals? I just find it upsetting that genuinely funny scenes like this, or sad scenes like Mufasa's death, are not gonna have the same impact as the original because the characters won't be able to emote. But with that, let's take a look at Detective Pikachu and how it handles emotion and expression. Now, while there are a lot of Pokemon in Detective Pikachu, the one we spend the most time with is, well, Pikachu, and the animators absolutely nailed having Pikachu being expressive. Remember how I brought up in the remake Simba didn't seem sad about his father's death? Well, here's a Pikachu looking sad. This is such a huge contrast in terms of abilities to emote, and a big part of that is because of how Detective Pikachu stuck to the original designs. Pikachu still has those big expressive eyes, but with the 3D rendering, the filmmakers were able to add facial muscles to really exaggerate and emphasize expression. You want a happy Pikachu? Here you go. Scared Pikachu got one here and here. Angry Pikachu got one of those too. Even outside of Pikachu, there are other Pokemon that are able to show emotion, like Apom and Jigglypuff. It just goes to show that realism isn't always better if it means losing the ability to exaggerate expression in order to convey emotion to the viewer. But this brings me to my final thoughts on the topic of remakes and 3D animation. In the past few weeks of promotional material for The Lion King, I have either seen people who feel like the remake will lose the charm and heart of the original because of its use of realistic animation. Or I see those who see 3D animation and realism as an upgrade and the superior form of animation. And then they promptly and rightfully get blasted in the replies. There is also the issue of people debating on whether Disney remakes should be shot for shot. This is a criticism I see with The Lion King and Beauty and the Beast, but in contrast with the Mulan remake, we see people upset that the film is not going to be shot for shot. There's the saying you can't please everyone, but based on Disney's remake streak in recent years, they seem to be nearly shot for shot, the only new thing being photorealism in animation. And when that's the only thing that's new, your film is obviously going to draw a comparison to the original. But when looking at Detective Pikachu, yes, it was based on a 3DS game, but the film and the game were two completely different stories. Thus, moviegoers couldn't really compare it to anything because it was a new interpretation on the Pokemon franchise. Whereas Disney and The Lion King looks to be going for the shot-for-shot method, and when doing so, moviegoers like myself will only be thinking to themselves about how absent the charm, life, and heart of the original is. I know that having the most realistic animation in movies or graphics in video games is what is sought after in the entertainment industry, but it reaches a point where everything becomes so set in realism that there isn't any room to push beyond the boundaries. This is where 2D animation excels. When it comes to 2D, there is no shortage of what you can show or portray. If you want examples outside of just the Lion King or Pokemon franchise, I have provided a link to a video containing outtakes from Robin Williams' performance of the Genie that has been storyboarded by Eric Goldberg. It is truly incredible what these animators can do, and sadly we are seeing less and less 2D animation in films. The last two 2D animated films for Disney were The Princess and the Frog in 2009 and the Winnie the Pooh movie in 2011. Meaning it will almost be 10 years since we last got an original 2D animated film from Disney. Instead of making something new, they opt for the obvious cash grab of remaking their classic 2D films. While I understand that the movie industry is a business, there can still be passion put into it. When I think back on films like Beauty and the Beast, The Little Mermaid, Aladdin, and The Lion King, I can see the passion and heart. But show me a remake and I just see the story and characters I enjoyed as a kid in a blander, less vibrant world. Ironically enough, by making the films live action, they have really sucked any life out of the film. I can't deny that what can be done with the technology is impressive when it comes to animation, and it's only going to keep improving. And to a company like Disney, it only makes sense to use this technology to bring back their classic films to both audiences, young and old. But I'll end the video with this. Just because you can do something, doesn't mean you should.